Okay. Let's see here. Frank Elko. Crimson Caravan. Robbery, murder, and... Okay. 500 dead. Assisted by his brothers Bill and Simeon, Frank Elko has turned the Elko Gang into a fearsome crew. The oft-inebriated outlaws have a reputation for speed and surprise, and while robbery is their priority, they will use lethal force. To indicate the gang uses their stolen property and caps to finance a ceaseless drinking binge at their hideout near the emergency rail station. Tactical considerations. Once sober, the Elko Gang is reputed to be a straight-shooting, disciplined crew. However, their propensity for consuming alcohol en masse might allow an easier tactical scenario, provided the bounty hunter uses proper stealth and subtlety in their approach. That was the Crimson Caravan. Alright. Or maybe not. Aha! Alright. They want him dead. The Wrath of Grapes, as opposed to the Grapes of Wrath. Wow! This is complete whiff. Really? About to say. Grab this while I'm here. Oh man! Ow! Ow! Oh, this is the worst thing that could happen. I'm dead. I'm dead because New Vegas is glitching out. Save the right Elko.
Got you now.
Right. Medics. Oh my god! 26 HP! Ow! Ow! Ugh.
What can I do for you?
Yeah, shut up.
Oh.
Frank Elko.
Alright, let me just authenticate that finger. Yeah? Yeah, you got the bastard. I hope you killed his brothers, too. They're a bunch of drunken savages. Here's your reward.
Okay. Alright, so next... We got him already. Adam Resnick. Postal location, registration, Charlie. Kidnapping, slavery, human trafficking, murder, slavery, trafficking, 500 alive. Ah, it's been a while since one of those. Adam represents the interests of an underground slave ring that continues to persist despite the NCR's best efforts to eradicate slavery. He's remained hidden for years, and therefore only a fraction of his crimes are documented. He coordinates the slave trade between raiders and a third party, likely a liaison for Caesar's Legion. Let's see, he's relied on secrecy to shield his operations, but it's doubtful he will surrender without a fight. Any contractor pursuing this bounty should be prepared for close quarters combat, as the target is known to operate indoors. Ranger Station Charlie. Aha! He is... Oh, yeah, I found this place before.
Easy there, don't shoot. I'm just looking to conversate. Haven't seen anyone around this ranch since the owner left for no apparent reason. I'm struggling to remember his name. Goddamn age is getting to me. That doesn't matter. I think I know why you're here. I've seen you before.
Oh.
Yeah, that bounty hunter worked for Stephen Randall.
You gave her a piece of me, huh?
Randall was a good man. He had a lot of anger in him, but still good in his core. It's a shame what happened. Anyway, I'm guessing you're looking for that slaver, right? Rezbaznik, or however you say it. He's a piece of shit. Every once in a while, the NCR passes through trying to find him. It's common knowledge he does business around the ranch here. But what they don't know is that he's right under their noses. His bunker's over yonder beneath that overpass.
Why are you telling me this?
I can see that you got something to say, so spit it out.
Are you helping me?
Randall did me a solid on more than one occasion, and I never got to thank him. I figure this is the next best thing. And I hate slavers, and will continue to do so until my dying day. 20 years ago, they took my wife from me. It ruined my life. I looked for years, but never found a trace. Even the men who took her are mystery. I figure getting back at old Rizm, fuckface, gives me a small sense of justice. Just get him, okay?
What are you doing here?
Oh, there's a lot of good scavenging, prospecting to be done down here. A lot of folks are scared of Legion, Jackals, Vipers, and Banditos, but they rarely roll through here in force. Most often it's just caravans and traders, especially those dealing in human commodities. Adam, or fuck his last name, you know who I mean. He's subtle enough to avoid the NCR, but I've seen where they're operating. Normally I say live and let live, but he's different. They call him the Butcher for a reason. He's a goddamn monster.
How'd you know Randall?
As a well-traveled prospector, I knew quite a few shady characters in the Mojave. Randall always paid well for information. Normally, I'm reluctant to share my secrets, but Randall was trustworthy, and he wasn't stingy with the cash. It was nice while it lasted.
Okay.
All right, kid.
Ah. Yeah, it's very interesting.
Hold it right there. State your business.
Is this how you treat customers with armed with an incinerator?
Excuse me. His office is the first door on the right.
Hey, come on in, have a seat. There's coffee if you like it. Make yourself at home. It's no rush, but when you're ready to talk business, just have a seat and we'll get started.
Oh, you're pleasant. All right.
Are you okay?
Later.
First, let me introduce myself. I'm Adam Resnick, and as you probably know, I deal in human property. I apologize for the dank setting, but the NCR's
dank memes will be good.
Some degree of secrecy. Now, what can I do for you?
Karma minus 100. Tell me about yourself.
Well, fair enough. My family moved here from some place called the Den. My maternal grandfather was some kind of big shot. I was left to fend for myself at a young age, so I joined up with the Jackals. After a misspent youth, I began this business. Now, thanks to some old contacts, I'm able to secure property at cheaper rates than my competitors, and that means more dinero in the customers' pockets. Now, the bad old NCR cramps my style a bit, and while that keeps me from offering a maximum discount, I can still beat anyone on the Mojave. I am a stupendous judge of character, and I'm sensing you're in need of a manual laborer. Am I right, or am I right?
Give me an overview.
Of course! Now, we've got a nice variety, so I'm sure there's property that will fit your budget. If you like them young, then we have a few boys ready to serve your every need. I can offer you the red-haired lad for $250. But if you're looking for a different sort of companion, all our female stock is on sale. They are muted, spayed, and utterly docile. Now, we have some adult males, very robust and eager for work. I could part with one of them for $750 or the pair for $1,200. You're thinking about the boy, right? Don't worry, we provide a 6-month warranty and free medical care for the property.
This is a terrible conversation. Color, right? It's
Don't
funny.
Worry,
oh, yeah, we got a 6-month warranty on him.
I'll start this paperwork while you decide.
There's a bounty on your head. I'm taking you in.
Okay, okay. Let's not do anything hasty, all right? You're not the first bounty hunter to come calling, I'm afraid. Look, I account for these sort of things when I estimate overhead. In fact, I have a special fund set up for this sort of situation. I sense that deep down you're a practical person. And after all, how many bounty hunters are idealists? In light of that, why don't we talk turkey?
Eventually, I'm listening with your offer. Eventually, the NCR bounty hunters or your own men will take you out. Do the time and start over. If you don't go willingly, I'm going to carve you into pieces. I'll just kill you. Do the time, man. Do the time.
You know, all this time I've been sleeping with one eye open, wondering when an escaped slave or an ambitious guard will take me out. I never wanted to do this. It's the only way I know how to survive out here. But maybe I can get a new start. It's ironic I'll wear the collar. I suppose it's fitting. Goodbye, bounty hunter.
And off he goes. Alright, what is this note? I saw it before I sat down. Let's unhighlight these. Ladies Batch, should fit the bill for your business. The females will fetch a nice turnaround if you fatten them up a bit. Word of warning, you better geld to those two males. One of them is a wild tribal. Even with their tongues cut out, I suspect they're planning some type of escape. .. There you go. Yay, karma. I should have anticipated that. I'm not sure why I didn't do it, but whatever. Come here, you.
One eternity later.
Alright, he's turned himself in. Frickin' finally. So I cut a lot of that out, but, yeah, he's like glitched or something.
Hey.
What can I do for you,
Yeah. Adam, what's his face?
Yeah, that silver tongue piece of shit came in, sure enough. He was always one step ahead of us. It didn't help that he was sharing the dividends of his business with several NCR officials, not to mention supplying the Legion with slaves. But as I might have predicted, he's cutting a deal with the prosecution. In exchange for information on the Legion, he's getting a lighter sentence. He's getting off easy, but either way, you got the job done, so good work.
Yay. Alright. Ah, we're on a new page. 16 through 20. Doug Rude. How rude. Dirty Doug. Independent gunslinger in a short stick saloon. Manslaughter. 500 alive. Well-traveled pistolero with a penchant for goading individuals into duels and then claiming self-defense if attackers killed remains. Not bold enough to challenge NCR officials, he has personally killed at least 3 contractors in duels, such as killing strangers. Makes his living as a gambler, drifting from town to town, using his reputation as a gunslinger to his advantage. He's a lone wolf, but still dangerous. Numerous gangs, at least one posse, have underestimated his prowess with a pistol. Does adhere to a loose code of honor, and can likely be prompted to surrender if defeated under his own terms of combat. Okay. The poster outside. Last time near Good Springs. Hey.
I recognized you the moment you strolled in here. You're the famous bounty hunter who wiped out Richter and Associates, right? I also understand that you gunned down Jack, Heck Gunderson's former gunman. I was privileged to work with Jack for several years. He was a fine shootist, lived his life according to the code.
I hear you're quite the duelist. Let's step outside.
That's what I was hoping for, actually. Meet me in the street, and we'll finish this.
Over here!
Oh, no you don't, my friend. So I got more, huh? Wow, he hits hard. Okay, let's cripple his arm. Mysterious stranger, why? Nope. Oh, storyteller. Gah. Oh, was not even paying attention that time.
It takes guts to meet me out here. I'll give you that, kid. That won't save you, though. Make your move.
Like
Okay, let's heal up some more.
I can't believe it. You got me.
That's all I wanted.
Okay, you win, you little snot. Just give me the fucking collar and I'll turn myself in.
I accept your surrender.
What can I do for you, young...
Doug Rude.
I think that old Pistolero's pride was hurt more than his body. Ever since Jack was killed, Doug was considered the fastest around. But, like they say, pride comes before the fall. You might want to keep that in mind. Good work out there, Hotshot.
Okay. Jake Burns. Postal location, NCR Military Police Headquarters, NCR Embassy. Okay, it's just there. Ah. Bootlegging, smuggling, murder. Going to NCR. They just want to kill him. Responsible for the murder of Captain Gary Winstone, along with his wife and family. He had uncovered his moonshine operation, had gathered evidence. However, Jake and a few brothers tracked him down and slaughtered the entire family. Any contractor pursuing this bounty, consult with him first. Okay. The bird's flight consists of 13 men and 3 women, all of varying age and relation. They are heavily armed and hostile to any and all outsiders, regardless of circumstances. Advised to utilize stealth or overwhelming firepower, as they will never engage in dialogue. And then his initial research. After several weeks of observation, I've gathered enough data to render a criminal case against the clan. They control an extensive smuggling operation, whiskey, narcotics, and moonshine to raiders, merchants, and anyone with cash, including a lone centurion who stops by each week. Oh, well, that's funny. Like, that one Caesar's Legion guy was like, hey, man, give me the stuff. Based on the brothers' conversation, I suspect the clan is headed by an unseen matriarch referred to simply as Grandma, while the brothers are eager to engage certain outsiders in commerce. They despise any trace of the NCR or government authority, insisting on autonomy and independence. I saw Jake Burns meet a trader who simply asked if the Burns traded with the NCR. I've been observing them in proper cover and in plain clothes, and I doubt they've spotted me. Besides, they exhibit traits indicative of a narrow gene pool, so their collective intelligence is suspect. The Grandma notwithstanding. Full documentation of their offenses will be submitted along with this report. Alright, buddy, let's talk.
What can I do for you?
I can't talk with him. Okay, do you guys have something?
What do you want?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, I probably need to get the poster first. I bet that's it. Yeah, police headquarters. There he is. No. Can't sit on the chair, fine.
What can I do for you?
Consult with you, why?
Yeah, I wanted to talk to you about this case before you set off. This case is personal for me. Jake Burns and his shit-kicking relatives killed one of my very good friends, Captain Gary Winstone. We had received some reports of an illegal moonshine operation near Crescent Canyon, so he started investigating. Right before Captain Winstone was going to uncover their hideout, well, those bum brothers tracked him down to his home. He was one of the first investigators on the scene, and it was fucking awful. I've seen some heinous shit in my days, but those animals. I estimate that they had their way with Gary's wife before they did both of them in, along with his 2 kids. They're fucking savages, and they've got to go. Now, officially, your only job is to kill Jake Bums, you know, the brother's ringleader. However, Winstone's reports indicated that they do operate as a clan with a matriarch at the top. And I want you to kill that old raggedy cunt. If you bag Grandma Bums, I'll throw in an extra 250 caps, no questions asked. Now I'm counting on you.
Okay. Oh, I see. It's a little... like bunker. Well.
What was that?
Nope, just gonna stay right here.
Anybody there?
Die, please. All right. Oh man, they are tearing into me. Absolutely tearing into me. Taste the flames of vengeance. Burn. Ow, frickin' dynamite. Ow. Evil gnome. See what the situation looks like in here. All right, let's go.
Like that?
Yeah, burning the Burnses. Can't even see the pain. The pain. More burning the Burnses. What gun did he even have? Deliver- oh, wow! Okay, let's sneak our way in one more time. Nope! That's a triple guy. Why aren't you dying? God. freaking ridiculous.
What can I do for you, young man?
Quick reward. Oh. Jake Burns.
Let me verify that. God damn right that's his finger. He was a real piece of shit, and we're all glad to see him go. Well, I'm happy to know that Jake's dead. I've got to ask you. Did you off Grandma Bums, too?
Yep.
That's good. Damn good, in fact. As promised, here's another 250. You did me right proud on this one, kid. Good job.
Ugh.